The port of Southampton lies on a peninsula between the mouths of the rivers Test and Itchen, and boasts one of the world's largest natural harbors. Until the 1930s, it was England's busiest port for transatlantic passenger travel, and giant liners like the Queen Mary were built in local shipyards. Number 1. Medieval City Walls. The best views of Southampton's 14th-century medieval walls, the third longest unbroken stretch of city wall in Britain, are obtained from the Western Esplanade, also the site of Wind Whistle Tower. The only remaining medieval church in Southampton is St. Michael's on Castle Way, built in the 11th century, and containing Norman relics and a font made of Tournai marble. Number 2. Tudor House and Garden. The magnificent Tudor House in St. Michael's Square was built in the late 15th century for a wealthy merchant family. Now a museum, it displays exhibits from the Victorian and Edwardian eras, as well as periodic exhibitions encompassing more than 900 years of local history. Number 3. The Medieval Merchant's House. Another classic old home to visit is the Medieval Merchant's House in French Street, just a short stroll from the city center. Built in 1290, this historic townhouse has been fully restored and is one of the only surviving examples of its kind. Number 4. Beaulieu and the National Motor Museum. An easy 14-mile journey southwest of Southampton through parts of the New Forest, the National Motor Museum at Beaulieu is one of the world's largest museums dedicated to the automobile. Its many exhibits include the official collection of original James Bond vehicles, as well as other famous movie cars, including the flying Ford Anglia from Harry Potter, as well as the homemade cars constructed for the Top Gear TV series. Number 5. SeaCity Museum. SeaCity Museum tells the story of the people of Southampton and their role in Britain's rich maritime history, including the stories of those who departed from, or arrived in, the port over the centuries. The Titanic story exhibit also tells of Southampton's connection to the ill-fated vessel, which sailed from the port in 1912. Number 6. Titanic Trail. The Titanic departed Southampton on her doomed maiden voyage to New York, and as a result numerous sites around the city are associated with the vessel. One of the best ways to learn about the city's connections to the ship is through the informative Titanic Trail. Number 7. Steamship Shieldhall. Part of Britain's National Historic Fleet, SS Shieldhall is the largest surviving working steamship of her type in Europe. Built in 1954 as one of the Clyde sludge boats, this impressive vessel has been fully restored and provides a working example of the machinery typical of the great ships that plied the world's oceans between the 1870s and 1960s. Number 8. Solent Sky. Solent Sky uses a fantastic collection of models and photographs, as well as numerous magnificent flying machines, to tell the story of Southampton's aviation heritage. The region is famous for its experimental and development work between 1908 and the late 1960s, the most famous being the iconic Spitfire. Number 9. Old Town and Bargate. Just to the south of the city center, Southampton's Old Town has many unique locations associated with famous residents and visitors. These include William the Conqueror, Henry V, William Shakespeare, the Pilgrim Fathers, Isaac Watts, and Jane Austen. Number 10. Ocean Village. East of Southampton's Old Town, Princess Alexandra Dock has been transformed into a modern leisure and shopping center. You'll see plenty of luxury yachts moored in the harbor in front of Canute's Pavilion, with its designer boutiques, gourmet restaurants, and cinemas, including one for art house and foreign language films. Hope you like this video. For more videos, please subscribe to our channel.